What's going on, YouTube? SciGuy29 coming at you for episode 75 of Crafts and Cards. Welcome to the beautiful cardboard pub. Hope everyone is doing well. Happy Super Bowl week. God, I hope it gets warm soon. Filming this and here in the middle of Iowa, it's another one of those shit-ass days that's just cold. Don't know how else to say it, but hope where it's, you are, it's great. Those in the Northeast, hope you're getting dug out and all that. Kind of gives you an idea when I'm filming this. So hope all is well there. Looking forward to the Super Bowl. Not going to get to watch all of it in person. I'll get to see the first part. And the end of the game, I've got season tickets to the Des Moines Civic Center and their Broadway series. So I'll be at the Saturday evening performance of Tootsie the Musical on Sunday night. But it's, what are you going to do? It's been so long. We've only had one show this year that we've been able to have, so looking forward to that. Let's get into some beer. Tonight's beer, a special beer. I've said it before, I know, that craft brewers are some of the most creative people you will ever find. Not just because of what they put in their beer, but the names they give them. And then on top of that, you have the artwork that goes on a can or a bottle. And wow, this one is certainly not going to disappoint, I don't think. This is Home Malone, a dunkel, by Barntown Brewing, West Des Moines, Iowa. I call it Waukee, West Des Moines. But look at that artwork. Just fabulous. There's the rest of the can. Good looking Iowa logo right there. But Barntown Brewing, one of my personal favorites. One of my top two favorites. This is a dunkel, so it's a darker beer. So as most of you know, right up my alley. But the Home Malone, just absolutely incredible when you come, it comes right down to it. I mean, it's just absolutely brilliant marketing. I'm going to put this back here so everybody can see it a little more. This is a dark German dunkel. 5.3 ABV. Easy drinking. 5.3 is pretty crushable. Anything below 5.5 to me is one of those. It's very seasonal. You can't find it very often. It's the first time I've ever found it. So I was very excited too. But here's the old light test. You can see dark like I like it. Cheers. Toasty, malty, just a smooth, not bitter at all. It did not, the website didn't have the IBUs or International Bitterness Units, but I'm guessing it's pretty low, which is typical of a lot of the Germans. There's a little bit of hop there at the aftertaste, but really, really good, strong beer, so. Put that over there. So with it being Super Bowl week, I thought, why not some football cards? So I pulled them out. If you've been watching the last few weeks, I've kind of been unloading a tote that I hadn't looked through in probably upwards of 20 years. There's a few football cards in there, not very many. So this is the stack that came out of the tub. And I've shown a few others, I think. And then I've got a stack, if we still have time, of some others that I'll share with you. So here we have a 91 action-packed Richmond Webb. And if you've never seen these, you can kind of see they've got raised parts. They're really kind of cool cards, but they're real kind of a pain in the butt to store. Here we have the same year Jerome Brown, defensive tackle for the Eagles. Here's a card that's very personal to me in my collection. Didn't realize I had another one, but it was stuck in the box. And this is a 96 Fleer Ultra Bryce Pop. Now, if you haven't heard me say on the channel, Bryce Pop grew up in a town 8 miles from where I live in Scranton, Iowa. Basically an unrecruited kid out of high school. There's the back of the card. But he went to the University of Northern Iowa. same school as Kurt Warner. They've had some really good players come out of there. But he ended up being defensive player of the year in the NFL. And obviously earned a scholarship. He went to school in the same building where I first started teaching in this district. So kind of a cool. Few more to go with them in that set. Little Bruce Smith. The Bills were such a dynamic team. Jim Kelly. They had so many other great players at that time. Here we have an upper deck. Neil Smith. With the Chiefs. Follow that up with another Bruce Smith. These are upper deck from 96 as well. Bruce Smith was a monster. Here we have a Fleer. Flair, 94 Flair, Wave of the Future. Dan Wilkinson. They called him Big Daddy, maybe. He's out of Ohio State, if I remember correctly. Does not say on there, but I think that's where he played. He's kind of a big fella. Also out of 94 Flair, here's the Heath Shuler, Wave of the Future. Follow that up with a gold score, 94 gold zone, Steve Young. Nice shiny card. Follow that up with a Fleer Pro Set Power, Power Prospect, Drew Bledsoe. And we have a 94 Fleer Hot Numbers, Jerome the Bus Bettis. Now we have a Bowman, Barry Sanders. Can't read the year. 93, I think it said, but good-looking Barry Sanders. One of my all-time favorites to watch play when he wasn't playing my team. Here we have a playoff. I love the playoff football cards. It was always one of my favorite. This is kind of the metallic. This is the draft playoff draft picks. Tyrone Wheatley. The backs were horrible, but the fronts, not sure this is really doing it justice, but great looking cards. Another Barry, or Emmett Smith from Stadium Club. And then we follow that up with a Jerome Bettis draft, what was this, Classic Four Sport. I think this might be numbered. And this is one of, I think it, can't tell if that says, like one of 20,000. See if you can read it. I don't know. Love the bus, being a Notre Dame guy. Here's another one of those playoff cards from 94 of Drew Bledsoe. Love that look of the color popping out of the black, the white, and the rest. Here we have a Marcus Allen playoff club. And what is this? Oops, that's a Kevin Brown that got in there for some reason. Art Monk, Game Breakers hologram. Can't really see Art Monk on there, maybe a little bit. Followed up with 88, John Elway. And yep, that price tag is what I paid. Here we have a action-packed Troy Aikman. And then a slabbed Pacific. I don't even know what this is. It's from 93. Joe Montana in the four screws screw down. I need to get that out of there, but I just found it. So there's the Joe Montana. All right. Got a little bit of time here. We'll just do a few of these. A few relic cards. Guys that played in some Super Bowls. Got an Isaac Bruce dual relic. This is numbered 22 out of 250. And this is from Donruss Threads, yes. So that's Isaac Bruce. Follow it up with a Kurt Warner. I think I've shown this before. This is a Panini from 17. Another Iowa guy. from Cedar Rapids. Here's a Junior Seau stat jersey. Okay, that's number two. But man, they put it right over the top. I don't know, 740 out of 1,058. Here's a Brett Favre out of SPX. Giant piece there. And we'll set it at this. Oh, let's do this one. No, we can't end on that. Oh, here we go. We'll end on this one. Great one to end on. This is a, man, numbered 159 out of 175. Panini 2015. Bob Greasy relic card off the white jersey. Was never a huge Greasy fan because he always seemed to overshadow Fran Tarkington, and that Fran was my guy. So Dolphins got it done when the Vikings couldn't. So I guess he deserved some of that. So hope all is well. Hope you're doing well. Hope the cards are coming in for you. Hope the beer's cold or the drink's cold, whatever you want. Doesn't even have to be alcoholic. Could be a Mountain Dew. Could be an iced tea. Certainly looking forward to the days where the iced teas are much more prevalent. So as the sign says, collect what you love. Love what you collect. Till next time, cheers.